Hello friends, welcome back to our channel Let's Learn and Grow Together. In the last lecture, we have started with the first unit of this course, that is Simple Stresses and Strains. In that lecture, we have covered three points, that is first one is definition of strength, then classification of material and the concept of stress and strains. So before going ahead with this lecture, we will just revise this concept of stress and strain. So for that we have considered a structural member which is fixed at one end and is subjected to an external load of P at the other end. So this external load ki wajah se this material will get deformed. So deformation, in this case this deformation is change in length, that is delta L, but due to it's a property of strength, material is going to resist this deformation. Wo kaise resist karega is deformation ko? Due to their intermolecular forces of attractions. Jo molecules hai is material mein, unme jo intermolecular bonding hai, aur us bonding ka intermolecular forces of attraction ki wajah se material will resist this deformation due to external load by producing an internal resisting force. This force is going to resist the deformation, so it is called as internal resisting force. So when we first apply this external load, material starts elongating, but as soon as this external load becomes equal to the internal resisting force, deformation will stop, and at that instant we are going to define stress and strain. So what is stress? Stress is nothing but internal resisting force produced in a body against the deformation per unit cross section of the material. So internal resisting force per unit cross sectional area of the material, but they are equal, internal resisting force and external load, because of the equilibrium condition. So stress is nothing but P by A. So unit is P is in Newton, area is in meter square or Newton per mm square, or it is 1 Newton per mm square is equal to 1 megapascal. And strain is nothing but deformation. Here deformation is delta L, so strain is change in dimension per unit original dimension, that is change in length per unit original length. L is in meter, this L is also meter, so strain is unitless quantity. So today we will see the types of stresses. So basically there are two types of stresses. First one is normal stress and second one is shear stress. So what is normal stress? When external load and internal resisting force is generated, or only internal resisting force is generated, are perpendicular to cross section, then the stress induced in the material or generated in the material is normal stress. But when the external load and internal resisting force generated, or only internal resisting force generated, is parallel or tangential to cross section, then the stresses generated are called as shear stresses. So this is nothing but normal stress and shear stress. When this external load and internal resisting forces, or internal resisting forces only, are perpendicular to cross section, then it is normal stress. And when these stresses are parallel or tangential to the cross section, then it is shear stress. But there are different loading conditions which are responsible for generating the normal stresses and shear stresses. So we will see the loading conditions responsible for the generation of normal stress. So first is axial loading. So when the axial load is applied, when the loads are applied along the axis, then these loads are perpendicular to the cross section and internal resisting force generated, they are also perpendicular to the cross section. So there are two types of axial loading. One is of pulling nature and another is of pushing nature. When it is of pulling nature, we call the stresses generated as tensile stresses, and when the external loads are of pushing nature, then the stresses generated are called as compressive stresses. So in this case, both in external load and the internal resisting force generated are perpendicular to cross section. So another condition is bending. In this case, the external load is not perpendicular to the cross section. So it is not perpendicular to cross section, which here it is perpendicular to the axis. So in this case, what is the effect of this type of loading? Material will get bent. So due to this bending, the upper layers are subjected to compression and lower layers are subjected to tension. These upper layers are subjected to compression and lower layers are subjected to tension. So this compression at the upper layers and the tension at the lower layers, the internal resisting forces generated are perpendicular to cross section. Which cross section? When we cut this beam vertically, then we get this cross section. So is cross section pe jo internal resisting forces bending ki wajah se develop ho rahe hai, wo perpendicular hai. So yahan pe नॉर्मल स्ट्रेस जनरेट होता है, पर ये बेंडिंग की वजह से जनरेट हो रहा है, इसलिए इसको हम बेंडिंग स्ट्रेस कहते हैं. अनदर कंडीशन इज बकलिंग ऑफ द कॉलम. जनरली कॉलम्स आर सब्जेक्टेड टू कॉम्प्रेसिव लोडिंग. सो कॉम्प्रेसिव लोडिंग हियर आल्सो द लोड अप्लाइड एंड द इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस आर परपेंडिकुलर. When material or the column gets buckled, in this case also these layers are subjected to tension and these layers are subjected to compression. So here also we will get normal stresses, that is stresses perpendicular to the cross section of the material. So now we'll see the shear stresses. So in this case, first of all, first shear stress is of direct shear stress. So in this case, the external loads applied are parallel to the cross section of the material. So in this example of rivet, this external loads are parallel to the cross section and internal resisting forces generated are also parallel to the cross section. So both internal resisting forces and external load are parallel to the cross section. So this is example of direct shear stress. So another loading condition is bending. हमने normal stresses में देखा, when beam is cut vertically, then वो जो section आता है उस पर जो stresses है वो normal stresses है. But अगर हमने इस beam को horizontally cut किया, horizontal section लिया इसका, तो उस horizontal section पे due to this sliding effect, here दिस एडजेसेंट लेयर्स ऑफ अ बीम, एडजेसेंट लेयर्स जो करीब के लेयर्स है एक दूसरे के, वो ड्यू टू बेंडिंग वो एक दूसरे पर स्लाइड करेंगे, और उसकी वजह से इस हॉरिजॉन्टल सेक्शन पे जो स्ट्रेसेस जनरेट होंगे और इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस, स्लाइडिंग फोर्सेस को अपोज करने के लिए जो जनरेट होंगे वो पैरेलल टू द क्रॉस सेक्शन होंगे। सो हियर इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस आर पैरेलल टू द क्रॉस सेक्शन, सो स्ट्रेस जनरेटेड इज शियर स्ट्रेस ड्यू टू बेंडिंग। एंड अनादर लोडिंग कंडीशन इज टॉर्शनल शियर स्ट्रेस। सो व्हेन ए शाफ्ट इज सब्जेक्टेड टू ट्विस्टिंग मोमेंट, ट्विस्टिंग मोमेंट दैट इज, और ए टॉर्क और ए शाफ्ट इज सब्जेक्टेड टू ए कपल कपल ऑफ फोर्सेस, सो दिस साइड ऑफ शाफ्ट इज सब्जेक्टेड टू एंड क्लॉकवाइज कपल ऑफ फोर्सेस एंड दिस साइड ऑफ शाफ्ट इज सब्जेक्टेड टू एन एंटी क्लॉकवाइज कपल ऑफ फोर्सेस। दिस टू फोर्सेस, कपल मीन्स टू फोर्सेस, सो कपल ऑफ फोर्सेस एंटी क्लॉकवाइज कपल, क्लॉकवाइज कपल। सो व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट दैट शाफ्ट विल गेट ट्विस्टेड। सो ड्यू टू दिस ट्विस्टिंग और टॉर्शन ऑफ द शाफ्ट द टॉर्शनल शियर स्ट्रेसेस आर जनरेटेड इन द शाफ्ट। सो दीज आर द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ लोडिंग कंडीशंस रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर शियर स्ट्रेसेस। सो ये जो बकलिंग ऑफ कॉलम्स एंड बेंडिंग ऑफ बीम एंड टॉर्शन ऑफ शाफ्ट्स, ये तीन यूनिट्स है, इनको हम डिटेल में हमारे आगे के कोर्स में एज अ सेपरेट यूनिट देखने वाले हैं। सो हम आज इस यूनिट में हम टेंसाइल स्ट्रेस, कॉम्प्रेसिव स्ट्रेस एंड डायरेक्ट शियर स्ट्रेस, इन तीनों की डेफिनेशंस एंड करस्पॉन्डिंग स्ट्रेंथ्स देखने वाले हैं। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद दी फर्स्ट दैट इज टेंसाइल स्ट्रेस। सो वी हैव सीन दिस टेंसाइल स्ट्रेस एंड कॉम्प्रेसिव स्ट्रेसेस आर टाइप्स ऑफ नॉर्मल स्ट्रेसेस। सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेस? स्ट्रेस इज डिफाइंड एज इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्स अगेंस्ट डिफॉर्मेशन, इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्स जनरेटेड और प्रोड्यूस्ड अगेंस्ट द डिफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द मटेरियल। सो नाउ कंसिडर ए स्ट्रक्चरल मेंबर विच इज सब्जेक्टेड टू एन पुलिंग लोड। सो व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ दिस पुलिंग? दिस स्ट्रक्चरल मेंबर विल गेट इलोंगेशन। सो इलोंगेशन, और उस इलोंगेशन को क्या करेगा, ये जो क्रॉस सेक्शन है इस मेंबर का, ये क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया है, यहाँ पे इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस जनरेट होंगे। सो ड्यू टू दिस पुलिंग फोर्स इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस विल गेट जनरेटेड एंड दे आर गोइंग टू अपोज द इलोंगेशन ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चरल मेंबर। सो बोथ आर परपेंडिकुलर टू द क्रॉस सेक्शन, दैट एक्सटर्नल लोड एज वेल एज इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस। सो दीज इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस आर अपोजिंग द इलोंगेशन। सो व्हेन इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस आर अगेंस्ट इंक्रीज इन लेंथ, आर अगेंस्ट इंक्रीज इन लेंथ, देन द सेक्शन और द स्ट्रक्चरल मेंबर, द सेक्शन और द स्ट्रक्चरल मेंबर इज सेड टू ऑफर टेंसाइल स्ट्रेस। व्हेन द इंटरनल रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस आर अगेंस्ट द इंक्रीज इन लेंथ, देन द स्ट्रक्चरल मेंबर और द सेक्शन इज offering a tensile stress. So it is denoted by sigma t, and sigma t is what is resisting force, internal resisting force R divided by area, or as per the static equilibrium it is P by A. Units are same as Newton per mm square or mega Pascal, and the corresponding strain is tensile strain, and which is tensile strain. Consider this two dimensional diagram of this. So this here increase in length is delta L and the original length is L. So change in length divided by original length, this is tensile strain, which is unitless. Similarly, now consider a structural member which is subjected to an pushing load, and this load is, what is the effect of this load on the structural member? It will try to decrease the length of the structural member, and against this deformation the member will offer an internal resisting forces, which are also perpendicular. These both the internal resisting forces and external load are perpendicular to each other, so, and they are up, these internal resisting forces are opposing the decrease in the length. So when internal resisting forces are against decrease in length, then the structural member is said to offer compressive stress. It is denoted by sigma c. So sigma c is equal to R by A or P by A. Units are same, Newton per mm square or mega Pascal, and the corresponding strain is called as compressive strain, and which is nothing but change in length, that is here decrease in length, which is dl divided by original length, that is l delta l by l, and it is unitless quantity. So this is nothing but tensile stress and compressive stress. Now we will see the definition of shear stress. So when the external load applied is tangential to the cross section of a structural member, then the internal resisting forces generated are also tangential or parallel to the cross section. So load which is acting tangential to the cross section, or force or load which is acting tangential to cross section, are called as shear force or shear load. And the internal resisting forces generated against this shear force are called as shear resistance. So shear stress is defined as shear resistance developed against the deformation per unit cross sectional area. So shear resistance, that is nothing but R divided by A. This is denoted by tau. So tau. But according to the condition of static equilibrium of the structural member, R is equal to P. So tau is equal to P by A. This shear stress also has same units because the formula is also same. So Newton per mm square or mega Pascal. So this is about shear stress. Now we will consider the deformation when the load applied is tangential. In the tensile stresses and compressive stress, the deformation is change in the size. But in case of shear stresses, when the loads are parallel to the cross section, then the deformation is the change in the shape of the material. Here size is not going to change, but the shape of the material is going to change. So strain is nothing but deformation or change in dimensions to the original dimension, but in this case it is change in shape. So shear strain is defined as, definition of shear stress, क्या हो रहा है इस लोड की वजह से, ये जो हॉरिजॉन्टल लेयर है वो डिस्प्लेस हो रहा है विद द लेंथ डेल्टा एल. सो दिस हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ अपर लेयर पर यूनिट और डिवाइडेड बाय इट्स अ डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम लोअर फेस और फिक्स्ड फेस. सो दिस इज एल, दिस हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज डेल्टा एल एंड द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द लोअर फेस इज एल. सो शेप चेंज हो रहा है तो हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्प्लेसमेंट डिवाइडेड बाय डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द लोअर फेस इज नथिंग बट शीयर स्ट्रेन. बट फ्रॉम दिस ट्रायंगल ए बी और ये बी डैश, सो ट्रायंगल ए बी बी डैश अगर हमने यहाँ पे टेन फाइव का फॉर्मूला यूज किया तो क्या होगा, टेन फाइव इज नथिंग बट अपोजिट साइड that is delta L divided by the adjacent side that is L. But deformations are generally very small, so when phi is very small we know that is tan phi is phi, therefore we can write phi is equal to delta L by L. So we know delta L by L is nothing but shear strain, so phi, that is shear strain is delta L by L, and this is unitless. So from this equation we can define the shear strain as angular deformation in a radian measure represents the shear strain. This deformation in radian measure represents shear strain, or it is also defined as change in the right angle of the element measured in the radians and is dimensionless. So you have to understand that we measure strain in the, or this angle in the radians, but it is dimensionless. We have to take it as a dimensionless. So suppose if phi is 10 degrees, so shear strain क्या होगा, 10 degrees होगा तो उसको हमको radians में convert करेंगे. इसको हम radians में कैसे convert कर सकते थे, 10 degrees pi by 180 degrees, degrees cancel हो जाएंगे और इसका जो answer आएगा वो shear strain होगा. हमें उसे radian नहीं कहना है, यूनिटलेस ही होगा और ये शीयर स्ट्रेन होगा. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट अबाउट शीयर स्ट्रेसेस एंड शीयर स्ट्रेंथ. सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव कवर्ड टाइप्स ऑफ स्ट्रेसेस. सो इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन और डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग दिस लेक्चर यू कैन आस्क अस इन द कमेंट बॉक्स, एंड टू गेट अपडेट्स रिगार्डिंग अवर नेक्स्ट वीडियोज प्लीज subscribe our channel and stay tuned. Thank you very much.